Royalty, royalty, powers of the chosen people.
All right, shalom, shalom. This is your brother Malachi coming at you with another lesson. But first and foremost, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Kadash. And in the ancient Hebrew tongue, that's the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His begotten Son, our Savior, Yahweh Shai. Also, I'm going to give a shalom to the men, women, and children waiting patiently on the return of Yahweh Shai, and also practicing and being in the spirit of love, peace, joy, and charity. So I'm gonna get right into it. This is actually Matthew chapter 7. I start at verse 8. It says, "For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Or what man is there of you whom is his son asks bread, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will he give him a serpent? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask of him?" It says, "Therefore all things," "therefore all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them, for this is the law and the prophets." I'm going to read verse 12 again. This is Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. It says, "Therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them, for this is the law and the prophets." The Lord is saying, what you want done unto you, you do to others, okay? You can say this is quote unquote Christian and all this stuff. Well, guess what? This is kingdom talk. This is what's going to get us as that precious elk, okay? Lord's will with that first fruit, okay? We want to make it, you know, into the kingdom the first go, okay? We don't want to come through the loins of the elect, because we're going to be, you know, shamefaced, okay? Like, damn, we didn't, you know, when we was in Babylon, we didn't get it right, okay? So this lesson is going to go into basically, do unto others how you want to be, how you want things done unto you, okay? The Lord didn't give us this understanding and give us this grace, this mercy to now belittle our people, okay? Belittle our enemies, okay? The Lord wanted us to show our people their transgressions, and speak boldly in the faces of our oppressors, in the sense of telling them what's going to happen, okay? Telling them that, you know, what the Lord, the indignation he has towards them, okay? But also us being in the spirit, man, okay? So I want to get into some accounts of basically Yahweh Shai and some of the prophets, you know, them always being in the spirit and always having that understanding of treat others how you want to be treated. That's no different than us today, okay? The Lord said that, you know, you have to be born again. You have to be renewed. You have to be innocent like a child, okay? And that goes into a lot of forgiving. That goes into a lot of gentleness. That goes into a lot of meekness, okay? This is, let me jump to Romans. Actually, no. I'm going to go into... Let's get some stories from the apostles or the prophets. Salakia. This is Acts chapter 7. I'm going to start at verse 45. It says, "Which also our fathers that came after brought in with Yahweh Shai into the possession of the Gentiles, whom Yahweh drave out before the face of our fathers, unto the days of David, who found favor before Yahweh and desired to find a tabernacle for the power of Jacob. But Solomon built him a house. Howbeit the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet, heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. What house will ye build me, saith the Lord? Or what is the place of my rest? Have not my hand made all these things? Ye stiff neck and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit. As your fathers did, so do ye. Which of the prophets have not your fathers persecuted? And they have slain them which showed before of the coming of the just one, of whom ye have been now the betrayers and murderers. So the prophets were always slain, okay, because they were teaching of Yahawashi. They were teaching of the just one coming, okay? It says, who have received the law by the disposition of the angels and have not kept it. When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, and they gnashed on him with their teeth. And this is Stephen, okay, Stephen. He was teaching, he was prophesying unto our people, man, being gentle, being meek. And he was just telling them what it is. He was telling them the truth. And they hated that. He said they were cut in their mind. They gnashed on him with their teeth. Verse 55, it says, but he being full of the Holy Spirit looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of Yahweh and Yahawashi standing on the right hand of Yahweh, and said, behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of Yahweh. Then they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord. So they were basically, once again, he was showing that light unto them, and that light was bringing out their darkness, okay? And they couldn't take it. So they basically shut their ears and they started charging after him, man. But let's see what Stephen did, man. Let's see what the spirit that he was in. It says, then they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord and cast him out of the city and stoned him. And the witness laid down their clothes at a young man's feet, whose name was Saul. And that was Saul of Tarshish. It says, and they stoned Stephen, calling upon Yahweh and saying, Lord Yahawashi, receive my spirit. And he kneeled down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And when he had said this, he fell asleep. So his last words, man, this is a prophet of the Lord, his last words were, Lord, please basically forgive them. Don't even hold this against them. He was in the spirit of Yahawashi. You think it's a coincidence that right after he said that the Lord basically let him rest? He was fulfilling prophecy, but also was showing you. Up until his death, man, he was a pattern, okay? Clearly a believer on Yahawashi, okay? This is how we have to be. Us coming into this understanding and this knowledge, you know, our emotions, our own desires and certain, you know, ways of doing things is all, that's all gone out the window, okay? We're now vessels of Yahawashi. We're now his building, okay? We're his temple. We're his, you know, we're the vessels. That's why, once again, the kingdom is going to manifest within us, man. So we got to be an example, you know, in and out. It ain't about, quote unquote, being soft or nothing, man. You got to be an example. That's what leaders do, okay? You lead by example. Yahawashi led by example. That's why people followed him, because he wasn't just talking, okay? And then what he was saying was contradicting the spirit he was in. No. He manifests that inwards and outwards, okay? This is how we need to be. And actually, let's get an account of Yahawashi. Being gentle, being meek. This is Luke chapter 23. And actually, this is when they were about to crucify Yahawashi. So let's see how our Savior, how he was up until his death, okay? Salaki, that's my son. But let's see how he was, because once again, if we're believers and followers of Yahawashi, and we understand that, and it tells you in 1 Timothy, which Lord's will I bring out, but he was that pattern, and we have to follow that pattern. Let's see an example of that pattern. This is St. Luke chapter 23. I started verse 21. It says, but they cried, saying, crucify him, crucify him. And he said unto them the third time, why? What evil have he done? So this is Pilate and you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, basically, you're asking for Yahushua's head, man, on a platter. You want him dead, or Salakia, a lot of our people did, okay? It says, and he said unto them the third time, why? What evil have he done? I have found no cause of death in him. I will therefore chastise him and let him go. And they were instant with loud voices, requiring that he might be crucified. And the voices of them, of the chief priests, prevailed. So even the chief priests, once again, of our nation, they wanted Yahawashi killed. Kill him, man. Kill that nigga, man. Have him. That nigga. Okay? They wanted him crucified. It says, and Pilate gave sentence that it should be as they required. And he released unto them, Salakia, and he released unto them him that for sedition and murder was cast into prison, whom they had desired, but he delivered Yahawashi to their will. So they, all right, now go sit down, buddy. So they basically, our people, you so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, okay, a lot of our people and the so-called leaders back then of the nation of Israel, they delivered him up. But in doing so, they let a sinner, an actual sinner, an actual murderer, they set him free. This is how much envy they had for Yahawashi, okay? But you know, this is what our people and the leaders of our nation, this is how they felt. Let's see what Yahawashi did. I'm gonna jump down to verse 33. It says, and when they were come to the place which is called Calvary, there they crucified him, and the malefactors, one on the right hand and one on the left. Then said Yahawashi, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his raiment and cast lots. So Yahawashi was being crucified, okay? The spirit was leaving him, and he's still saying, listen, Father, please forgive them. They do not know what they're doing. They have demons on them. If they were in their right mind, they wouldn't even be this way. They would know we're one nation. They would look at each other as brothers and sisters, okay? Yahawashi was an example up until his death, just like his prophets were, man. You can't get around this. You can't get around this. You have to have the fruit of the Spirit, man. We have to be examples if we are going to call ourselves the hopeful elect. If we're going to say, you know, we want and we strive to be you know, the first fruits, okay? Those who are crowned through Yahawashi, okay? It says, then Yahawashi said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his raiment and cast lots. So he still forgave them, and they still had that envy. Showing you, we have to be an example up unto death. People going to scoff, people going we ain't got time for this. I know who I am, okay? They going to say all types of things. That don't mean that we change who we are, man. We still show mercy. If we have the light, we have the understanding, and we got to look past our carnal feelings right now. We're now focused on the kingdom, okay? Let me get another account. When... I think it was John. Come on. This is St. Luke chapter 9, verse 54. And when his disciples, James and John, saw this, they said, Lord, will thou that we command fire to come down from heaven and consume them, even as Elias did? But he turned and rebuked them and said, ye know not what manner of spirit ye are in. For the Son of Man is not come to destroy men's lives, but to save them. And they went to another village. So James and John, they was basically about to turn up on some guys because they was they felt as though they were disrespecting Yahawashi. Yahawashi saw automatically. Yahawashi didn't get upset at the guys who James and John said that they were disrespecting Yahawashi. He didn't say, "Yeah, man, kill these niggas, man. Anybody that disrespect us, anybody that don't accept this truth, kill them." Yahawashi actually got mad at James and John. He rebuked them. Why? Because they knew better. You said you're a prisoner of the Lord, right? You put your life down for me, right? You took up your cross, right? All right then, be an example, man. Get out your carnal feelings, okay? And be an example. Matter of fact, I think my phone's going to die pretty soon. So, Salakia, Lord's will, I can finish. I'm going to Romans chapter. This is Romans chapter 12. Yeah, Romans chapter 12, verse 14. It says, "Bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not." So if someone is persecuting us, okay, someone is making it, giving us a hard time or making things difficult, okay, you don't curse them. You don't render evil for evil. Bless them. Hey, man, you know, I hope you come out that spirit, man. May you help Hashem, Yahawashi, show you the way. Shalom. And keep it moving. The pattern for us was already set. We have to follow that pattern. Okay? You're about to have a lot of people coming to the prophets, man. A lot of people are going to seek out this knowledge, man. Ain't no damn coincidence you got 25,000 troops down in D.C. Okay? Now they're saying there's a threat in all 50 states. Okay? I live by damn the Quantico base. I keep hearing, you can tell they're doing drills. All you keep hearing is, off in the distance, you can hear, you know, bombs and stuff going off or maybe artillery, but I can hear it now. Whether it be tomorrow, the next day, whoever, who knows? Next year, it's coming, okay? But us in this understanding, we're going to have to shine that light, man. So until Yahawashi comes back, until he gives us that green light to be hunters, okay? Until he sets that standard, we have to be gentle, meek, okay? Our forefathers, they all, up until their death, okay, had this gentleness about them, had a meekness about them. We have to be the same way. And actually, I'm gonna end it here. This is Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 23. "Have I any pleasure at all that the wicked should die?" The Lord is asking, do I have any pleasure that, quote unquote, two-thirds, you wicked so-called Black, Latinos, and Native Americans, do I have any pleasure that they should die? "Saith the Lord Yahweh, and not that he should return from his ways and live." So Yahweh, while Yahawashi would rather our people come back to his ways, okay, come back to being a separate nation, come back and getting out of these heathen subscriptions, these heathen ideologies that have us drunk, okay, out here on this world stage. He would rather us come back. So that's what we have to have in the back of our minds, in the front of our minds, man. That these people that we're calling niggas, they ain't shit. I would have kicked your ass in the world, this and that, all this craziness, man. Keep it in your mind that whatever you're sowing, the Lord, he's going to repay you for that. Okay? But also keep in your mind that the Lord, he would rather that that person that you're cursing out, the person that you're calling a nigga, that person that you're putting down, just like they get put down every day in a society from every other nation. Now you add none to that. Just know that the Lord, he would rather that person come back to him, man. And how would they do that? How can they even get an example to do that? You, if you have this understanding, that's the only way. If you get, you show them an example, and of course, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai gives them that green light to, okay, you know, show this person mercy. But you have a job to do too, man. So I pray that this lesson was edifying. Kol halal Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakar Kadash. Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. Wa Abad Babal. This your brother Malachi, signing off. Shalom, Yasharallah.